where you can substitute cello for, you know, violin. Yeah, okay. They have... Yeah, and they both have stringed instruments. I mean, yeah, who couldn't get those two confused? Cello and violin. There you go. Right. I should probably not try to walk when I'm just perfect this time of night. It's just... Okay, so I just walked through more of the part of Williamsburg, and it's just lots of people who are just standing and stopping and be like, hey? I'm like, oh, come on, people, just move. Put up a special commuting, if you will. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, the video will be online later tonight. So you can take a look at what the walk was like and probably even hear parts of the conversation again. Reminisce. So I'll shoot that too. Oh, my bike has two cameras on it. I think I turned them on. And then, so because I always ride with the cameras on, I'm pretty sure I turned them on. Just to record, and then I put the videos up on YouTube at the end of the day. Yeah, in kind of like a raw video format. Eventually, I think I might do something with it. But now it's just kind of like a random documentary of what's going on. I had no idea if they're picking up my voice or not. But they're on, they were definitely picking up the trip through and around and above. And so, YouTube, about a year ago, was it? Almost a year ago, YouTube approved my account for unlimited video uploads of both time and quantity. So I thought I would put all of the videos I've ever recorded on YouTube. So I've uploaded like something like 2,000 videos, and every day I've 2,000. I think so. A lot of them are still private because they're like biking and just I just did a bulk upload of all of the ones that I've ever had. So I still have to like tag them and make them public. But I realized this week, last week, that my ride to work, I can upload my morning videos for work at work and at night. I can upload my videos on the way home, and be starting to put more stuff up. And I don't know if I think I've got like 3 followers total. If I had time, I'd edit them, but right now I'm just putting up the raw footage, and I'm putting it up in a community commons kind of aspect, so people can use it, edit it, do whatever they want with it. It just requires attribution for YouTube policy, like, yeah, we took this book from Matthew, blah, blah, blah. So, Creative Commons, that's the one. Yeah, so like all the videos I put up are Creative Commons marked. They can use it. So people can mash them up or do whatever they want with it. And I'm just tagging the videos that I am putting up with the bikes every day and putting them up there. And I've got to go back through all the rest of them and put them up. Hopefully, I'll get a lot of them. They'll go up, and I just got to make them public. One of these days. So yeah, so not I would say only a few hundred out of those 2,000 are public right now. I will send you the link to my channel, and you can browse to your heart's content and see a lot of the ones that go up are biking videos. Just my commute to work and other things, because I ride with the camera on the front and the back. I shoot some other videos with my phone sporadically, but I'm not as good at uploading them. So when I get those up, those will just kind of pop up eventually. Best I can say with that. So, yeah. Nice. Absolutely, like, I don't know how you mash up things on YouTube, but if you do it inside YouTube or download it, but if you see videos, like, just send me, like, what the video is, I can give you the full video kind of thing. So you can, yeah, like, because they're all AP and fun stuff and things like that, so. Put everything online and do it with the best knowledge of it. So I did. And I'm still working on that. You know, I'm trying to streamline it, so I've got, as long as, you know, if I take the same route to and from work, I've got all the tags that kind of come up, and I just put a little summary of what I saw, like my little summary will be like, blah, 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 weather, this, this, and that. And it's like, I had a great chat with Rob on the way back. So I'm using it as a little bit like as a diary to kind of keep track of what I've been doing day to day. We'll see if that works. But that's where I'm at. You know, that's what I'm up to and what's going on. Yeah. They're on good mounts on the bike, but then again, they're not on vibration-free mounts for the bike. So, some parts are better than others. That's the best I can say. I'm sure Final Cut has a vibration reducer thing that will help, or a stabilizer. I'm shooting these in HD. I'm shooting them in HD at 60 frames per second, so they're 1280 by 720 at 60 frames per second. And, yeah, that seemed to be a good frame rate and resolution. I can do higher frame rate, lower resolution, or higher resolution, lower frame rate, but this gives people a chance to slow things down, you know. And you can also reduce the... you could do some image stabilization and some other things are just part of the image. And, I've also been exploring, like on my own, about time-lapse and do me a favor, like when we're done, mailing address. I have one of the cameras. I have three cameras, but one of the cameras, The lens is actually screw in, and then they're kind of essentially glued into place. Well, one of the lenses, the glue broke, so it's out of focus. And all you have to do is focus the lens, and then the camera will work. If you're interested, I'd be happy to mail you the camera. You can then, screw the lens back in to the right spot, glue it in place, and you have... like your video and a video or camera again, if you'd be interested. If that's more. Yeah. Because I know that you are very detail oriented in that respect. From our work with the last time I had a camera that was a little funky and you somehow fixed it. This one I know what's wrong with it. I just don't have the I have another one. I think it's the same model. I got a couple years ago. I just haven't been shooting as much with it. So, yeah. Yeah, I mean, quite frankly, I got it because it's a DSLR. And, I don't need a hot... Yeah. So the camera that the little video camera is called a GoPro, and the model is the Hero 2. So, yeah. So yeah, I will, text me your address, your mailing address, and I will send one over to you, this one, and basically you just have to, I've actually taken it apart, put it back together twice now. Just have to take it apart, power it on while it's apart, and then screw in the lens until it's in focus, because right now it just takes blurry pictures. Everything works, it just takes blurry pictures because it's been so... I've had it for 2 years, and it's just the little bit of Loctite or whatever it is that held the lens in place shifted, and so it's out of place.
Yeah.
So.
Go it down.
And there you go. I know you're going to be accomplished with this, and you'll be doing like not stop motion, time-lapse pictures and all sorts of cool shit. I mean, and I'll also tell you this, I have an iPhone 5 that I'm thinking about upgrading to the new one. So, the only thing wrong with the iPhone 5 is occasionally I drop it. It has a very fine crack on the screen that is about 2 weeks old. So, I would be happy to, once I upgrade, send that to you as well if you'd be interested. Yeah, let's... Okay. If you can avoid the contract, you will. Totally. Yeah. Like I said, there's I wish I could figure a way to send you a... It's like you can only see the crack in the screen from two angles. Like if you have to... Yeah. That was... Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. The audio and video work. And I think that you can even replace the screen. I think you go on eBay, you buy the key, you replace the screen, and you're fine. We'll make that. What I will do, I will see what my... No, because I really like to upgrade, personally. So let me see, and the new phone doesn't come out until the 5th. No, I'm sorry. The 20th. So once I get an idea of what my cost is to upgrade, I figure like $100 or $200 probably be fine. If that works for you. Perfect. So I like the sound of that. Because that'll get me the new phone and all sorts of good stuff. And get you a new phone as well. Oh yeah, I... Right. Yeah. Yeah, and if you're coming from a 3G, this phone will blow your fucking mind. Totally will blow your mind. Like, well, it blew my mind coming up from the 4. So I know this is going to be a really crazy good step up for you. Good. Exactly. Perfect. I don't know, my phone went beep and said, call failed. I'm like, damn it.